Thank you for your kind introduction, Pastor Choi. And it is my great privilege and pleasure to speak to you tonight. My message will be focusing for, you know, young audience today. 오늘은 제가 이제 청소년들을 위주로 해서 영어와 또 이렇게 한글로 이렇게 바이링글로 진행을 하도록 하겠습니다. Disability could happen to anybody at any time. One out of ten children is disabled at school. After age 54, one out of four becomes disabled, totaling 54 million with disabled in the United States alone. And disability happened to me when I was a teenager. I have suffered many losses as a teenager. My father passed away when I was 13 years old, and when I was playing soccer ball as a ninth grader, and I got a hit from the soccer ball, which was the cause of retinal detachment. I had been hospitalized for 2 years for reattaching the retina. The doctor performed numerous operations and gave complete bed rest, but in vain. But I was born into a Christian family, and I had a faith that Jesus will cure my blindness. So I was seeking faith healing for 2 years, but God did not heal my eyesight. I became totally blind. I was really disappointed, and I was protesting and complaining to God, why me? Why God gave me this kind of disability to me? But I met Apostle Paul as my role model. Apostle Paul had some kind of disabilities. He asked God to remove it. He prayed to God to remove it, but God didn't heal it. Instead, God said to him, "My grace is sufficient for you. My power is made perfect in weakness." So I learned God will use my disability as a positive asset, like Apostle Paul's. So I stopped complaining and protesting to God, and I began to accept my blindness as a positive tool of God. Since then, I do not consider my blindness a handicap. I consider my blindness as a tool of God to bring the kingdom of God to to this world. 저는 그 이렇게 소년 시절에 부모도 또 시력도 그 모두 잃었습니다. 그런데 이제 그 시력을 잃은 다음에 하나님께 정말 그 왜 나에게 이러한 시련과 그 역경을 주시느냐고 이제 불평하고 원망하고 방황하는 그러한 삶을 살았습니다. 그런데 우리가